was on a dreary New Year's Eve, as the shade of night came down. Our Lord, Lord of Volunteers, approached the border town. There were men from Dublin and from Cork, Fermanagh and Tyrone, and the leader was a Limerick man, Joseph Bungario. And as they moved along the street up to the barrack door, they scorned the dangers they might meet, their faith had lay in store. They were fighting for old Ireland to claim their very own. And the foremost of that gallant band was Seth Bungario. But the sergeant spied their daring plan, he spied them to the door. Then dangled down the rifles, a hail of deadly roar. And when that awful night was past, two men lay cold as stone. There was one from near the border, and one from Gario. No more he'll hear the seagull cry, or the murmuring Shannon tide. For he fell beneath a northern sky, with Hanlon by his side. They have gone to join that gallant band, a plumpy pierce and stone. Another martyr for old Ireland, Joseph Bungario. Another martyr for old Ireland, Joseph Bungario. This land is your land, this land is my land, from the northern highlands to the western islands, from the hills of Kerry to the peaks of Derry. This land was made for you and me. And I was walking by the Shannon waters, hand in hand with my little daughter. And the church bells ringing, and the children singing, this land was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from the northern highlands to the western islands, from the hills of Kerry to the streets of Derry. This land was made for you and me. And I went home then by the village steeple, proud of my country, proud of my people, of the men who cried there and the men who died there saying, this land was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from the northern highlands to the western islands, from the hills of Kerry to the peaks of Derry. This land was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from the northern highlands to the western islands, from the hills of Kerry to the streets of Derry. This land was made for you and me. Let the people sing their stories and their songs and the music of their native land. Their lullabies and battle cries and songs of hope and joy, come join us hand in hand. All across this ancient land, throughout the tent of time, it was music that kept their spirit free, those songs of yours and of mine. those who are in love. Here's a song so warm and tender for those who are oppressed. It's song you can't protest. So liberate your mind and give your soul expression. Open up your heart, I sing for you this song. Let the people sing their stories and their songs and the music of their native land. Their lullabies and battle cries and songs of hope and joy. Come join us hand in hand. All across this ancient land, to answer the test of time, it was music that kept their spirit free. Those songs of yours and of mine. It was back in ancient times, the bards tell stories of the heroes and the villains, of the chieftains in the clans. To Elizabethan times and Cromwell in war and fury, for the pipers to the sword, till the harbors and the bars. Let the people sing their stories and their songs and the music of their native land. Their love eyes and battle cries and songs of hope and joy. Come join us hand in hand. All across this ancient land, throughout the tents of time, it was music that kept their spirits free. Those songs of yours and of mine. Oh, Ireland, land of song, your music lives forever in its mountains, in its valleys, in its hills, and in its glens. Our music is divine, to famine and oppression, for the generations gone, I sing to you this song. Let the people sing their stories and their songs, and the music of their native land. Their lullabies and battle cries and songs of hope and joy. Come join us hand in hand. All across this ancient land, throughout the test of time, it was music that kept their spirits free. Those songs of yours and of mine. Let the people sing their stories and their songs and the music of their native land. Their lullabies and battle cries and songs of hope and joy. Come join us hand in hand. All across this ancient land, throughout the test of time, it was music that kept their spirits free. Those songs of yours and of mine, it was music that kept their spirits free. Those songs of yours and of mine.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Rat Kitchen. Yoo-hoo! How are you, Kim? How are you, Sean? Kieran? Alan? That's all I can see at the moment. Jared. Hi, Cheryl. Hello, Pauline. Jeez, Thomas is still in prison. Oh my God. Welcome everyone to the Rag Kitchen and me bottle of tea. Don't forget now, this is a rebel session, folks. And I'm going to be doing nothing but rebel songs for the entire night. So, if you want some special song sang, sing it. Or send it to me, and I'll sing it, if I know it. And if I don't know it, I'll learn it. I've three or four brand new songs gone in tonight, into the show. And I was up at 6:30 this morning learning some of them. And... oh jeez, there's one I totally forgot. Thanks, Pauline, for reminding me. It'll be in the show, hopefully tomorrow. The Patriot game. Hello, Greta. Good to see you. CB Bonner's on. James Connolly will be signed tonight, Ellen, that's for sure. Hello, Elisa. Jez, all the gang is here. Is Albrick in? I saw Lars coming in there, alright. Thomas is banned.
He can still watch
it. How long is he banned now?
Oh, nearly a week.
Jesus.
Are you happy saying fuck the Brits? Because somebody report you.
Oh, is that what you said?
Yeah.
F the Brits?
Yeah.
Somebody's bound to report you saying things like that. There's Brian Lankins in. Fool of Folk Take 2 will be in tomorrow because I didn't get around to it today. Pool of Ash, as Russell says. You don't flip that down. There's Chris Flavin Sweeney's in there as well. Chili Farrell. Jeez, there's an M and a half. Chili. How are you, Chili? How are you doing? Right, I better get on and start doing a couple of songs. Here's a song called James Connolly. Alan just asked for this one there a minute ago, so might as well do it now. Let's do it later.
A great crowd had gathered outside of Kilmainham, their heads all uncovered, came out to the ground. For inside that burnt prison lay a brave Irish soldier, his life for his country about to lay. He went to his death like a true son of Ireland, defying party he bravely did face. When the order rang out, present arms and fire, James Connolly fell into the ready-made grave. The black flag was hoisted, the cruel deed was over, gone was the man who loved Ireland so well. There was many a sad heart in Dublin that morning when they murdered James Connolly, the Irish rebel. Tis many long years since the Irish Rebellion, when the guns of Britannia they loudly did speak, and the full IRA they stood shoulder to shoulder as the blood from their bodies flowed down Sackville Street. God's curse on New England, you cruel-hearted monster, your deeds stay with shame, all the devils in hell. There are no flowers blooming, but the shamrock is growing on the grave of James Connolly, the Irish rebel. The four courts at Dublin, the English bombarded, the spirit of freedom they tried hard to quell. When the fog of the din rose the cry, no surrender, 'twas the voice of James Connolly, the Irish rebel.
There you go, Alan, to James Connolly. That's also for Ross McGee over there in Edinburgh, James Connolly's town, of course. And the second James Connolly that I do, Ross will be in later on in the show, I promise. Just remind me as we get into the second half, okay? And we'll do that one as well. Hello, Brian. The Roll of Honour, of course, will be in tonight. Absolutely, 100%. GBJC. I have no idea what that means, Ross. Must be good. There's Lucy's in as well. Good to see you all out and about virtually on a Saturday night to join us here in the Rag Kitchen, folks. And there's my good friend from Arklow County Wicklow, Paul Terrell, and a fantastic musician in his own right. Hello, Paul. How are you doing? Online gigs now, I'm afraid, my friend. But that's life the way it is. Here's a couple of songs that I always do together, one after the other. And the first of these is a beautiful ballad, the ballad of Billy Reid. And as most people know, I had the absolute pleasure of singing this particular song in the Rock Bar in Belfast with Billy Reid's daughter, Donna, a few years ago. And that memory has stuck with me and probably will stick with me forever. So I'm going to sing that one right now, and I'm going to follow that directly with, what's the name of the one I'm going to do, Russell? I might as well be asking the fridge. It's called Farewell to Ballaghy, the ballad of Thomas McElwee. So hope you enjoy these, folks, and hope you have an old swally there, would you? Have an old swig of the old cup of tea, or the bottle of tea, if you have a bottle of tea, or a can of tea. So long as it's tea, it doesn't matter, okay? Right, here we go.
I'll sing you a song of a terrible run, and the flying tail flew out of mast, and the man who lay dead, he was riddled with lead, and he died on the streets of Belfast. Oh, the radio said, there's another shot dead, and he died with a gun in his hand. But they never said why Billy Reid had to die, for he died a free Ireland. It happened one day when the bold IRA came out to free Belfast with an old Thompson gun, but the troops on the run and returned to home with their plans. Oh, the radio said, there's another shot dead, and he died with a gun in his hand. But they never said why Billy Reid had to die, for he died a free Ireland. On returning his gun, Billy met British Hun, and when the fight had begun, his position was dire, his gun wouldn't fire, and he died with an old Thompson gun. Oh, the radio said, there's another shot dead, and he died with a gun in his hand. But they never said why Billy Reid had to die, for he died a free Ireland. Although he lay dead, he was kicked in the head, by the hair they dragged him around. But they still fear him, yet sure they'll never forget how brave Billy Reid stood his ground. Oh, the radio said, there's another shot dead, and he died with a gun in his hand. But they never said why Billy Reid had to die, for he died a free Ireland. If you think you was right, come and join in the fight, come out and free Belfast. For the blood Billy shed, and alone he lays dead, in our hearts his memory will last. Oh, the radio said, there's another shot dead, and he died with a gun in his hand. But they never said why Billy Reid had to die, for he died a free Ireland. Oh, the radio said, there's another shot dead, and he died with a gun in his hand. But they never said why Billy Reid had to die, for he died a free Ireland. Farewell to Ballaghy, likewise Camlan Down, and the green hills of Derry that I dearly love. My thoughts return to you from my darkest block cell. old friend and great comrade, I bid you farewell. For hundreds of years now, we've kept up the fight, and the history books told me a wireless line. So with gallant Francis, I have followed the call to conquer the tyrant and to find England's lost. Farewell to the light, like white and the dawn, and the green hills of Derry that I dearly love. My thoughts return to you from my darkest blocks down. So friends and great comrades, I bid you farewell. To the hills of St. Derry we marched and we drilled, till our exploits in action all Irish it thrilled. Both fear men in a star, volunteers on the run, we give England their answer from the barrels of our guns. Farewell to the laddie, likewise come the dawn, and the green hills of Derry that I dearly love. My thoughts return to you from my darkest blocks down. So friends and great comrades, I bid you farewell. Oh, gallant St. Derry, you're forever blessed in the struggle for freedom. You have given your best. There's hues and there's bays, Sheridan and Lee, and the stride of their names now, great Tom McAwee. Farewell to the laddie, like white town of dawn, and the green hills of Derry that I dearly love. My thoughts return to you from the darkest blocks down. So friends and great comrades, I bid you farewell. Farewell to the laddie, like white Canada, and the green hills of Derry that I dearly love. My thoughts return to you from my darkest blocks down. So friends and great comrades, I bid you farewell. So friends and great comrades, I bid you farewell.
There you go, folks. The Ballad of Billy Reid and Farewell to Billy, the Ballad of Thomas McElwee. Right, Russell, what have we got?
Do you know Kimberly Monaghan?
I do know Kimberly Monaghan, yes. She's in Philadelphia.
Yeah. Were you expecting that from her?
No.
At least you're bobbing there for you. No addresses or anything.
Oh, Kimberly just bought us a couple of pints. Thank you very much, Kim. Really? Kim, really?
Anyway.
Thank you so much.
John Anderson got us a couple of pints there, as did Mary Huff.
Mary Huff in North Wildwood, New Jersey, bought us a couple of pints as well. Thank you very much, Mary. And also to John Henderson over there in Jersey, in the Channel Islands, who also bought us a couple of pints. Thank you very much, John.
Whew. Brian McCombie is looking for a song for Marcella, Road of Honour.
I haven't learned the song for Marcella yet. I always say yet because the list is endless at this stage. Roll of Honour is coming up right now.
Read the roll of honor for Ireland's bravest man. We will be united in memory of the ten. England, you're a monster. Don't think that you have won. We will never be defeated while Ireland has the sun. In those dreary hedgehog cages, ten brave young Irishmen lay. Hungering for justice while their young lives ebb away. For the right as Irish soldiers, and to free their native land. They stood beside their leader, the gallant Bobby Sam. Now they mourn his infamy, dream of reaching Armagh's hill. In those narrow streets of Derry, they miss O'Hara still. They so proudly gave their young life to break Britannia's hold. Their names will be remembered as history unfolds. So read the roll of honor for Ireland's bravest men. We will be united. England, you're a monster. Don't think that you have won. We will never be defeated while Ireland has the sun. To the war-torn streets of Ulster, the black flag is standing way. To salute an Irish martyr, the bravest of the brave. Joe MacDonald, Martin Harson, Devon Lynch, here Dr. Dean. They gave their lives for freedom with Thomas McAleen. Michael Devine from Derry, you were the last to die. With your nine brave companions, with the martyrs dead and alive. Your souls cry out, remember, our deaths were not in vain. Fight on and make our homeland and nation once again. So read the roll of honor for Ireland's bravest men. We will be united in memory of the ten. England, you're a monster. Don't think that you have won. We'll never be defeated while Ireland has the sun. So read the roll of honor for Ireland's bravest men. We will be united in memory of the ten. England, you're a monster. Don't think that you have won. We will never be defeated while has the sun. No, we'll never be defeated while Ireland has the sun.
Read the roll of honor. Sláinte.
Gary?
Yeah, there's a couple of songs I've been asked for there, and don't worry, I won't forget them. Right now, I want to do a a Cork song. The night was dark and the fight was ended. The moon shone down O'Connell Street. I stood alone where brave men perished. Those men have they're gone to me, and the forest I met was a gray-haired father searching for his only son. I said, old man, there's no use searching, for up to heaven your son is gone. And the old man cried out broken hearted, bending o'er, I heard him say, I knew my son was too kind hearted. I knew my son would never yield. My only son was shot in Dublin, fighting for his country bold. He fought for Ireland, and Ireland only. The heart, the shamrock, green, white and gold. And the last I met was a dying rebel, bending low. God bless the cause for which I die. My only son was shot in Dublin, fighting for his country boy. Ireland only. The heart, the shamrock, green, white and gold. The heart, the shamrock, green, white and gold.
There you go, folks, the dying rebel.
Phew. There's Jenny is on. Hi, Jen. A big welcome to Ray Coleman, originally from County Tyrone, but living over the United States. Another great musician. Hope you're well, Ray. God, we're having right a lot of people coming on. And there you go. That's what it's all about. A lot of people coming on. What else would you be doing on a Saturday night? I mean, everybody's locked up at this stage. And we honestly don't know for how long, but you're here, we do what we have to do, don't we? Now I'm going to introduce a couple of new songs, and hopefully you'll like them. And if you don't, sure, what can I do, you know? That's the one I was looking for. Diddle dee diddle diddle dum. Oh yeah. Right, this next song is a song that I've never ever sang before. And She was going to have a go at it and see what happens. And
Rory,
what's that?
There's Rory.
Oh, there's my son Rory. Rory's on. How are you, son? How are you keeping? Hope you did all right today. If you're out in the ocean, mind yourself out there, my boy. Anyway, we're going to get on. And as you all know, folks, this is a rebel show tonight. I'm not doing any ballads tonight, so every song I sing will be a rebel song, including this brand new one. God bless this lovely land of mine.
God bless this lovely land of mine. God bless the mountains, the hills and the valleys. Someday the sun will cease to shine. I deserve this lovely land of mine, this land of mine. The old man said we'll be alive when we are dead. My father's words on my mind. God bless this lovely land of mine. God bless this lovely land of mine. God bless the mountains, the hills and the valleys. Someday the sun will cease to shine, and I'll deserve this lovely land of mine. To misty eyes, as in my land, I hunger for a future grand. What greater hunger could there be? I hunger still be all right and free. God bless this lovely land of mine. God bless the mountains, the hills and the valleys. Someday the sun will cease to shine. Then I'll deserve this lovely land of mine. My gallant comrade has passed away, but with this song I sing today. I sing my song before I die. God bless this lovely land of mine. God bless this lovely land of mine. God bless the mountains, the hills and the valleys. Someday the sun will cease to shine. Then I deserve this lovely land of mine. God bless this lovely land of mine. God bless the mountains, the hills and the valleys. Someday the sun will cease to shine. Then I'll return this lovely land of mine. God bless this lovely land of mine. God bless the mountains, the hills and the valleys. Someday the sun will cease to shine. Can I deserve this lovely land of mine? Can I deserve this lovely land of mine?
That's not bad, was it? For a first effort, it's not too bad. I'd be happy enough with that. I have a couple of really, really, really beautiful new songs going in here tonight, folks. So stick around. I'll be adding them in very shortly. But anyway, somebody there was, I think it was Brian, was asking for Highland Paddy. I like that song.
One evening fair as the sun was shining, to Kilkenny, I did ride. I did meet with Captain Brady, called Commander by his side. Then we were welcome, Highland Paddy. By my side would surely stand, here the people's Jack of Arena. We ride in the morning with the beaming band, rise in the morning with the beaming band. In the morning we will bury. Just before the break of dawn, that red singing in the bones is creeping to a violent morn. Gather round me, men of Ireland. Come on, pinions, gather round, hand to hand with sword and musket, till the blood upon the holy ground. Then warm welcome, Highland Paddy. By my side will surely stand, hear the people shout for the freedom. We'll rise in the morning with the Freedom Band, rise in the morning with the Freedom Band. There's a glen beside the river, just outside of Kenny Town, where a vest of snow becomes a manly dead upon the ground. And you are welcome, Highland Paddy. By my side you surely stand, hear the people shout the freedom. We rise in the morning with the Freedom Band, rise in the morning with the Freedom Band. There's a grave beside the river, a mile outside of Kenny Town, where we laid on old guns and birds would sang and the Freedom died. All my life I will remember, I'll remember night and day, the ones I rode in Kilkenny, and there's the old captain say. And you are welcome, Highland Paddy. By my side we surely stand, hear the people shout the freedom. We rise in the morning with the Freedom Band, rise in the morning with the Freedom Band. And you are welcome, Highland Paddy. By my side we surely stand, hear the people shout for the freedom. We rise in the morning with the Freedom Band, rise in the morning with the Freedom Band, rise in the morning with the Freedom Band.
There you go, folks. Alan, yes, I do sing Kevin Barry. Sure as a Botany Bay is not a rebel song, so it can be in tomorrow night. But I will definitely do Kevin Barry for you in a little while.
Yeah, if you're also looking for Pardon Me for Smiling, you know that one?
The what?
Pardon Me for Smiling.
I've never heard of that.
Okay, that's all right then. And Little Armalite.
My Little Armalite.
Armalite, I spelled it wrong, yeah. Sorry.
I was looking for that one.
Also, Alan Border.
Jeez, Alan, you're flying tonight, boy. Oh, yeah. Alan's up there in my hometown of Arklow, County Wicklow. I hope you're spreading it to everyone there, Alan. You're welcome. Tell the family I said hello, won't you? Haven't seen her for years, but sure, there you go. What else is happening, Russell?
Right, let's see there. I did Highland Paddy for Brian Langdon there. He's also looking for Sam's song.
Okay. Yeah, we'll get to that as well, Brian.
Okay, John Henderson is looking for Provo's Lullaby or Black Watch.
Okay. I'll do Provo Lullaby right now. And the Black Watch, I do it, but I haven't done it for quite a while. So if you leave me alone with that, John, and I'll do it for you tomorrow. I'll just have to go through it again. I don't want to just mess it up, you know what I mean? If I'm not 100% sure of it, I'm always on edge. Jeez, there's Charlie. How are you, Charlie? Haven't seen Charlie Biore for a long, long time. He's down there in Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. Good to see you on there, Charlie. I knew you were going to ask for that one, Polly. You love that song, so I will definitely be doing that as well. Don't you be worrying.
Is that for John Thomas?
She
was asking for that because what's his name is Barry?
Thomas?
Yeah.
You're asking for Thomas, were you? All right. Okay. Right, I'm going to bring in a song I've also never done before, and I only actually sat down with it today. So I just...
Charlie's busy at work, he said.
Oh, Charlie's busy, okay. Well, Charlie, we all have to work, you know what I mean? This is my work at the moment because there's nothing else out there. And that's not the only reason. This keeps me sane, it keeps my friends happy as well, so... Anyway, here's a new song that I'm bringing in. Somebody asked me for this a couple of weeks ago, and I had never sat down with it. An absolutely beautiful song. And it's about Joe McDonald, basically, and what left behind, what his thoughts before he died, about what he was leaving behind. It's called A Father's Blessing. So hopefully I don't mess this up. Children's laughter, children's tears, Childhood joys of childhood years, fondest memories of our once happy home. It's not death that brings the pain, I would face it all again, but it grieves me so to leave you all alone. Do the wee ones still sigh when they hear their daddy's day? Do they sadly ask you why I won't be home again? How hard it is to know I'll never see them grow. Let my dying pray for them a better land. May they never let go the fears that have blighted my young years, or the shackles that have bound my native land. May they see the joy of life and not cruel civil strife. Foreign laws imposed by brutal strangers' hands. Do the wee ones still sigh when they hear their daddy's name? Do they sadly ask you why I won't be home again? Oh, I'll never see them grow. Let my dying bring for them a better land. May they grow in love and truth. Let them blossom into you, guided by their mother's loving hand. May they cherish Ireland's pride, for this Joe MacDonald died. Let them know their father loved them and his land. Do the wee ones still sigh when they hear their daddy's name? Do they sadly ask you why I won't be home again? Oh, how hard it is to know I'll never see them grow. Let my dying bring for them a better land. Do the wee ones still sigh when they hear their daddy's name? Do they sadly ask you why I won't be home again? Oh, how hard it is to know I'll never see them grow. Let my dying bring for them a better land. Let them know the Father loved them.
There you go, folks, the Father's blessing. That's, of course, John MacDonald's thoughts. And if you don't know who John MacDonald is, really, folks, you shouldn't be on this page. Do you like that, Russ? Thanks, Lisa. Hello, Bridget. I don't know the boys at Kilmichael. I have it on the to-do list. Or Oisha de Vahawalia will never be sang because it's not a rebel song. And if it is, I can't understand it because I don't speak Irish, which is a terrible shame for me. But that's what happens when you're a young fella in school of you no interest whatsoever. The only interest I had was the young ones that were in the school next door. And of course I got kicked out when I was 14. For good behaviour, of course. Cheers. And of course, when the headmaster was kicking me out of school, he said to me, "You will never be anything." I told him to fuck off.
Anything now, Ross, Russell?
What? Okay. Right. Alan, yeah, we got through with him. Brian Langan, Samsung.
Right.
Howard Whittle is looking for Joe McDonald.
We'll do Joe McDonald as well tonight, of course we will. Right, I'm going to do the Samsung. If I can find it, I'm still not 100% sure of it, so I have to use the words. There you go. Yeah. So now, I hope you like the Father's Blessing, lads. I worked hard on that. I have to say, I love the song. And thank you to those few people who actually requested that song, because it made me look at it. And there's a couple of other ones I'll be bringing in tonight as well that are brand new. So please don't go anywhere. There's some new songs coming in. And of course, when I've got some time, I'll be looking at other ones and bringing them in as well. So thank you very much, Lisa. I don't know what you mean there, Bridget, but you're anyway. Samsung. Well, I have been a coroner for 14 years or more. I've earned the likes and mark of undecorum and used gold. But now we have a weapon we've never used before. The reaper and the wave. And it don't go anymore. Junkie, I'm stay out the ride. Out the ride. And the light in the sky. Well, I ain't fired it out with petrol bombs and bones with the stones. The more left like me, I never was alone. But soon I learned that friction don't want to try to whisk the way. The world's very wrong before. I joined the IRA. Jackie, in the sky. When the beam is turning dear, you're up to the one. Ooh! Ah! The first thought we were beaten, that we were on the run. On that early of this morning, they kicked in my back door. For every man that they took, they missed a hundred more. Jockey out, sing out the round, go out the round, and the signs in the sky. I've been 8 years in the cages, I've climbed the distance line. Woo! Rolling up the way a boy, I walk down a man. There's only one thing that I learned while in the bell I'm based. The rich one never leave us until they're blown away. Jackie Anna, sing up the rhyme. Ooh, wow. In the sky. Up to the days of hunger strikes, I watch my comrades die. Ooh! Ah! And in the streets of Belfast, you can hear the women cry. Ooh! Ah! I can't forget the massacre that
left all, I salute my fallen comrades. As I watch the shepherds fall, Juckiala, sing out the rush,
go out the rush,
and the sight in the sky. Juckiala,
thanks, Lars. Phew.
Do you know the teddy bear's head?
I know the song, but I've never actually sang it. Russell, do me a favour, will you? Yeah. Cross that fridge. Oh, Jesus. Jeez, he has the fridge wide open. He's going to freaking
freeze me. You were the last person to open the fridge. Excuse me, mister. Yeah. It was you.
Sorry, it was me.
Well, you're sleeping in the fridge.
Oh. Smart arse now he is.
Oh, hey, I'm smarter. You're the stupid one. Hey.
Oh, now he's called me stupid.
Anyway. Having a tip in the kitchen.
Huh?
We're having a tip in the kitchen.
He says we're having a tip in the rack kitchen. A tip? Shut up, you feckin' big girl's blouse. Night was icy cold, I stood alone, waiting for an army foot patrol. Then at once they came into my sight. I squeezed the trigger of my arm alive. Oh mama, oh mama, comfort me, for I know these awful days have got to be. But when the war for freedom has been won, I promise you, I'll pull away my gun. The shots rang out, I heard a soldier cry. Oh, please don't leave me here alone to die. I realized his patrol had run away, left a wounded comrade for me to slay. Oh mama, oh mama, comfort me, for I know these awful days have got to be. But when I promise you, I'll pour away my gun. There's nothing in this world I wouldn't give if mercy's in your heart you let me live. And in his eyes I saw as the muzzle of my gun moved toward his brain. Oh mama, oh mama, comfort me,
For I know these awful things I've got to be. But when the war for freedom has been won, I promise you I'll put away my gun. The dawn was breaking as I reached my base. I can't forget the look on that boy's face. Fear and grief and worry were all there. But to your memory, Mama, I spared. Oh, Mama, oh, Mama, comfort me. For I know these awful things have got to be. But when the war for freedom has been won, I promise you I'll pull away my gun. Oh, Mama, oh, Mama, comfort me. For I know these awful days have got to be. But when I promise you, I'll pull away my gun. I promise you, I'll pull away my gun.
Charlie Burry is after buying some CDs, after.
Some CDs?
Yeah.
Thanks very much, Charlie. They'll be in the post on Monday.
What's that? Brian Langus sent us a pint as well.
Brian sent us a pint too. Thank you very much. I want to show you something, folks. If you remember the last time I was doing a live show, which was Tuesday, I sang a song that I wrote for my son before he lost his life to suicide 18 years ago. And everybody seemed to enjoy the song. It was very difficult for me. It took me a couple of days to recover after it. But what I did do is I ordered from my CD reproduction company the CDs, and I just want to show you this. And this is the recording that I did of I Can Never Be the Same. Okay, it's on its own on this particular little CD. I recorded this in Germany. I was actually living in Germany at the time. I recorded this in Lüneburg with two guys from one of the biggest rock bands in the world at the time, which a band called Force 10. There's two boys, Jimmy and Martin, from Force 10. The two boys were from Scotland, and they came in and done lead guitar and bass on it with me. And I played it here for the first time in 17 and a half years last night when the CDs came in. I played it on my own CD player here, and I was completely, completely blown away. I didn't realise how good the bloody thing is. And that's the CD that all the people that sent me their addresses, you're all going to be receiving those in the post. They will be going into the post office on Monday morning. So wherever you be in the world, if you've sent me your address, you're getting one. I don't know when it'll arrive at your door. But it will be sent on Monday morning. I'm going to spend all day tomorrow when I get up at 6:30 in the morning again. I'm going to be sitting down and writing the names and addresses of every single one of you. And those CDs will be in. So there you go. I hope you enjoy it. Russell hasn't even heard this yet. He was supposed to come over early, but he was too feckin' lazy to get off his bum off the couch. So he didn't come up to hear it. So now we'll have to wait till the show's over. He can hear it then.
That was better than anything.
You what?
I heard it live, you sitting beside me, that was better than anything.
Oh no, live is not better than what you're going to hear when this is over. It's fabulous, honestly. Claudia, hope you enjoy it, folks, and it's my way of sort of giving back. Do you know what I mean? I mean, you guys take the time out of your day to come onto my show. You buy me a couple of drinks, you buy my CDs. But what's more important is you keep my sanity at least on a level that I can manage. Because as you know, I have a lot of problems with mental illness. And I'm not the only one, of course. There are millions and millions and millions of us all over the world. But I'm dealing with it slowly but surely. So that's the situation. You'll be all getting those. And what are we going to sing now, Russell?
Right. I don't know. I got another request. What's to say about My Little Armalite?
Well, My Little Armalite, yeah, I'm going to do that one.
Yeah, Paul McGarry is looking for that now as well. Okay, as Paul. Order, so.
Paul and Alan. Okay. And after that particular song, after My Little Armalite, I'm going to sing that second James Connolly, the working man, just for Ross McGee over there in Edinburgh. And all the boys in the James Connolly Society in Edinburgh as well. It was an absolute pleasure a few years ago to actually perform for you guys. And to be honest, I'd love to do it again. So if you're doing something, Ross, you have all my details. You can contact me at any time. So there you are now. And before I start this song, I would like to say a big thank you to all my appointed admins on my group page. You guys have been absolutely amazing. And the work you do is just phenomenal. And I'm so grateful. I can't express how much it all means to me, because I can't do it all myself. And to Russell here as well, because Russell goes out of his way. Every time I come on live, Russell's here. Practicing safe sex in the kitchen, in the raw sitting room, while I'm in the raw kitchen. Okay, so yes, I will sing My Old Man's Approval. Chucky Arlaw, Brian says, good man. My Little Armalite. I'm not 100% sure what key I sang this in. It's quite a long time since I did this.
And it's down along the bald road, it's where I long to be. Lying in the dark with the poor company. A comrade on me left eye, another one on me right. And a clip of ammunition for me, little arm of light.
That's it.
I was stopped by a soldier, said he, you are a swine. He hit me with his rifle and he kicked me in the groin. I begged and I pleaded, oh, my manners weren't polite. But all the time I'm thinking of the little Armalite. And it's down in the bog side where I love to be. Lying in the dark with the Provo Company. A comrade on me left eye, another one on me right. And a trip of ammunition for me, little Armalite. Well, this brave war, you see, man can march in the first street. 600 British soldiers, he is lined up at his feet. Come out, you cowardly Fenian, come on out and fight. He cried, I'm only joking, when he heard the Armalite. And to stand by the light is where I long to be. Lying in the dark with the Provo Company. A comrade me left eye, another one on me right. And a trip of ammunition for me, little Armalite. Well, the army came to visit me, it was in the early hours. With Saracens and Saladins and turret armored cars. They thought they had me cornered, but I gave them all a fright. With the armor-piercing bullets of me, little Armalite. And it's down in the new lot, it's where I long to be. Lying in the dark with the Provo Company. A comrade on me left eye, another one on me right. And a trickle of ammunition for me, little Armalite. Well, when Prior came to Belfast to see the battles run, the generals, they had told him, we've got them on the run.
but corporals and privates, when on patrol at night, they remember now to walk around the little arm of light. And it's down across my glen, it's where I long to be, lying in the dark with the poor company. A comrade on me left eye, another one on me right, and a tip of vanity to burn me little arm of light. And it's down along the falls, oh, that's where I long to be, lying in the dark with the poor company. A comrade on me left eye, another one on me right, and a gift of ammunition for me with a lime of light. My little arm of light. Right, before I go any further, I'm going to bring in something that I think is probably the most magnificent song that I have ever heard in my entire life. And I didn't know it. I didn't even hear it until yesterday. And then I fell totally in love with this song. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to have a go at it, because I love it so much. I don't know if I'm going to fake it up or not. I hope I don't. It'd be a good idea if I could find it. But I have it here, don't you worry. There it is. That's a bit awkward there. Now we have it, I think. Wait, this is a song that all these new songs that I'm bringing in, by the way, they've all been requested by somebody on the live Rat Kitchen Sessions, right here where you are right now. And it could be you, because I don't remember who actually requested it. I just make a note of the song in the to-do list. And when I put this in the to-do list, I didn't know it, never heard it. So I looked it up and I listened to it. And I thought, oh my God, that's beautiful. So what I did is I sat down with it yesterday, and it affected me so much that I literally cried when I was singing it. Now that doesn't happen very often, but literally the tears were running down my face. This is the story of Padraig Pearse's last letter to his mother before he was taken out and executed. And there was only one person who requested this song that I can recall. And I would like to say a momentous, momentous thank you to you for requesting that particular song. And it is now my favorite song. And I do fully intend to record this particular song. So I'm going to have a go at it. And if I fake it up, well, I do. But if I do, I won't pick it up the next time. Okay? So here's this beautiful ballad called, well, it's not only a ballad, it's a rebel song. It's Padraig Pearse, just before he was executed. And it's called My Last Farewell. Good idea if I make sure it's in the right key though. I actually had the good sense of writing the key on the page, because I was going to start that in the wrong one. Okay, here we go. Dearest mother, I am writing just to say I won't be home. There's something that I have to do, and I must do alone. They have took me, and they put me in this lonely prison cell. Tonight my thoughts are with you as I say my last farewell. So say goodbye to Margaret, Mary, Bridget, and me all. I have no words to tell you how much I miss you all. And though I may not show it, you know I love you well. So in my final letter, I will bid my last
Won't you take good care of all the folks for me? Go home to Rathfarnham on the day you set me free. I was happy when you stood by me in all that we've been through. No one has ever had so true a brother such as you. So say goodbye to Margaret, Mary, Bridget, and me heart. I have no words to tell you how much I miss you all. And though I may not show it, you know I love you well. So in my final letter, I will bid my last farewell. Dearest mother, it's so very sad that now we have to part. To understand the reasons would trouble your poor heart. I have told you since I was a boy, it was my destiny to die to brave soldier so that one day you'd be free. So say goodbye to Margaret, Mary, Bridget, and me all. I have no words to tell you how much I miss you all. And though I may not show it, you know I love you well. So in my final letter, I will bid my last farewell. So say goodbye to Margaret, Mary, Bridget, and me all. I have no words to tell you how much I miss you all. And though I may not show it, you know I love you well. So in my final letter, I will bid my last farewell. So in my final letter, I will bid my last farewell.
My last farewell. Thank you to the person who requested that. I absolutely, absolutely love it. I hope you guys did too. It will be on my next album, and that is an absolute problem. Promise.
Problem.
A problem. Promise. It must be the feckin' Bulmers. Sláinte, lads.
What's next, Russell?
Not after that one. Something a little bit faster. Oh yeah, Pauline asked me to do my own as a promo.
Yeah.
So I'll do that. Just especially for Pauline Kennedy over there in Scotland, who is taking care of poor Thomas, who's still in Facebook prison since last Monday. Oh Jesus, they mustn't really like you at all, Thomas. Seriously. You must have done something really bad. Mind you, I got a warning this week as well. But sure, I don't give a shit. They can warn me all they like. I'll do the lives from Russell's page if they ban me, so. Or I'll do it from somebody else's page.
No, it can be done on your life page.
Oh, it can be done.
It'd be from my account, but it can come out as you. Yeah.
That's all right. You see, it can be done, so we won't be going anywhere. Pauline says Thomas is raging. I really, my heart bleeds for you, Thomas. I know how fucking stupid that can be. And as if it's not bad enough that we're in this fucking lockdown with the virus, but Facebook put you in lockdown as well. It's fucking disgraceful, I think. But you're anyway. Slaunch you, lads. Thomas, you'll be over it soon enough. And you'll be seeing me soon enough too, because when this is all lifted, I'll be over in Scotland. And we'll have an old sandwich or two. Or three. Or maybe even four. We might even allow Pauline to join us. Yeah, right, try keep her away.
Is Fenian Record here or something?
What's that?
Fenian Record here.
Yeah.
The Ballad of Willie John McFadden. I'll do it after this one. But I have to do this one. For Pauline and Thomas. My good friends, who are so loyal, it's unbelievable. Love you both.
My old man, the provost, with a berry and a gun. I haven't seen him lately. He's always on the run. He looks so really trendy with the shades and the end boots. And cooler down all the other ties and shirts and suits. Well, the Brits and Peter ask me each time that I go out. They ask me if I've seen me down or if he's been about. I say, mind your own business. Just leave me alone. You sure are only jealous, Jean. Nobody's on your own. Well, my old man's a provost with a berry and a gun. I haven't seen him lately. He's always on the run. He looks so really dandy with his shades and the end boots. Back cooler down, rolls up down the tight and shirts and suits. On our tea last Friday, a cop came on to say he'd give us information about the IRA. They showed a parole unit on security TV. I know I must be daddy, cause he stuck away with me. Well, my young man's a provost with a berry and a gun. I haven't seen him lately. He's always on the run. He looks so really trendy with his head on the end boots. But cooler down, loads up and down. Now me dad's got me worried. I think he's going soft. There's half a ton of fertilizer stored upon our lot. Are you gonna be a farmer, dad? I asked him just for fun. He said, don't be an idiot. That's the coffee grinder's son. Well, my old man's a provost with a berry and a gun. I haven't seen him lately. He's always on the run. He looks so really trendy with his shades and the end boots. My cooler down, loads up and down, and tight and shirts and suits. At Christmas time slowly, when me daddy's gone at home, the police are watching everywhere. They've even tapped the phone. Last Christmas Eve, they staked out all our windows and our doors. Them climbing down the chimney came a provost Santa Claus. Well, my old man's a provost with a berry and a gun. I haven't seen him lately. He's always on the run. He looks so really trendy with the shades and the end boots. But cooler down, loads up and down, the tight and shirts and suits. Now me guy's up in long cash. Now to me it's just not right. I say a special prayer for him when I go to bed tonight. Today it was his birthday. I sent him in a cake with Semtex in the candles. He'll be up before I wake. Well, my old man's a provost with a berry and a gun. I haven't seen him lately. He's always on the run. He looks so really trendy with his shades and the end boots. Back cooler down, loads up and down, the tight and shirts and suits. Well, my old man's a provost with a berry and a gun. I haven't seen him lately. He's always on the run. He looks so really trendy with his shades and the end boots. Back cooler down, loads up and down, the tight and shirts and suits. Well, my old man's a provost with a berry and a gun. I have haven't seen him lately. He's always on the run. He looks so really dandy, even shaving being booked. But cooler down, oh, double down, the times it's just a stoop. But cooler down, oh, double down, the times it's just a stoop.
Yeah.
Big strong man.
Yeah, we'll get that down in a minute.
Big strong man for John Conroy is looking for that.
Okay, John. No bother.
Yep. Gary O'Brien is looking for, I know it's a slower one, back home in Derry to mark Martin McGuinness's 70th birthday today.
That's not a slower one. That's a good song. Back home in Derry. I certainly will, Brian. Gary, certainly. In a few minutes?
Yeah.
Okay. Anything else?
Patriot game?
I'm still working on it.
Yeah, Pauline's looking for that as well. Yeah. Spancel Hill?
Oh, tomorrow night. Yeah. This is a rebel session.
Billy Reid?
I've already done it.
Oh yeah, no matter. Lucy, Teddy Bear Skating, we talked about that. Loch Hall Martyrs?
I'm still working on it, it'll be in probably tomorrow.
Okay. What have we got? Do you know a song called Scapegoat?
No, I've never even looked at that.
Birmingham 6 anyway, but John is looking, John Henderson is looking for that.
John, I will get to it. I'll put it on the to-do list. I'm taking off those slowly but surely, so I'll put it on and have a look at it when I get a chance.
Alan Murder is also Kevin Barry, 19 Arches.
I'm not doing 19 Arches tonight. This is a rebel session. I'll do it tomorrow night, but I will sing Kevin Barry tonight. So, right. That'll do for now. Here's the ballad of Willie John McFadden for the Fenian McCurplair. Well, wee Willie John McFadden was a lawyer Orange Broad. He thought that Ian Paisley was just one step down from God. They thought they hit the children in the backwoods of Ardoyne. And he thought that history started with the Battle of the Boyne. And he thought that history started with the Battle of the Boyne. Well, one day he took a brick in his hand and he wandered up the fall. He was mumbling up the rangers in Hollandary's wall. He broke a big shop window to annoy the Pope of Rome. Then he took a red card player out and then he staggered home. Then he took a red card player out and then he staggered home. Well, next night they held a hoolie in the local Orange Hall. And Willie took his player to make music for the ball. He chose a stack of records of a very loyal kind. But when the music started up, he nearly lost his mind. For this Fenian record player was a rebel to the core. They played the song of the Orange Hall I'd never heard before. For Dolly's Bray and Derry's Walls, it didn't give a fig. And the speed of God Save the Queen till it sounded like a jig. And the speed of God Save the Queen till it sounded like a jig. They played the Woods of Upton and the Wearing of the Green. Such turmoil in an Orange Hall had never yet been seen. They played the Boys of Wexford and the Men of 98. But when I played the soldier's song, it seemed to be Willie's fate. For the boys when he met it, did the ground be Will the Throne. And he kicked his ribs in one by one to the tune of Gary Owen. They threw him out the window to a song of Belgian fame. And they kicked them all down Sandy Road to a nation once again. And they kicked them all down Sandy Road to a nation once again. Well, this Fenian record player was heard no nevermore. They prodded it with taking holes and threw it on the floor. But yet it was not finished for the strangest sight you'd see. For the flashes flying out of it were orange, white and green. For the flashes flying out of it were orange, white and green. Now young Willie's up in Perry's barn, he's crazy as a coot. He sits there in his padded cell and doodles with his flute. But when he tries to play the bass, he always gets it wrong.
For half a two, we always find his playing the soldier's song. For half a two, we always find his playing the soldier's song. There's a moral to the story, what it is I cannot say. It's maybe just the ancient one that crime will never pay. If you ask, we will match pageants, we say a crime is lost. If you want to pinch a record, clear it up to Shankill Road. If you want to pinch a record, clear it up to Shankill Road. Hey!
There you go, lads. The feeding record player. The Ballad of Willie John McFadden. Right, I promised Ross McGee I'd sing this song in the second half, so it's an a cappella song. I don't use the guitar, in other words. And thank you very much, Richard. Thank you very much for taking off his hat to me all the way from Glasgow. Don't you worry, I'll be in Glasgow when this feckin' virus lifts. You can come to the show and see it live, Richard, and you're crack. Oh, by the way, Russell just reminded me, in the meantime, folks, if you feel like buying us a pint, please go ahead and do so. The link is there. If you want to buy some CDs, there's three albums, Rebellion, Resistance, and Songs of Irish Freedom. You can buy all three of them for €25, and a postage is your own choice. Somebody sent me €700 the other day for three CDs. I couldn't believe it. And then I looked again, and it was 700 crowns. It wasn't making euros at all. But that's all right. So there you go. Anyway, here's a song called James Connolly, the Working Man. Especially for Ross McGee and the James Connolly Society of Edinburgh. Where, oh, where is our James Connolly? Where, oh, where is that gallant man? He's gone to organize the union so that working men they might yet be free. Then who will lead the band? Then who will lead the band? Who bought our James Connolly, the hero of the working man, who will carry high the burning flag, who will carry high the burning flag, who bought our James Connolly, will carry high the burning flag. Well, they carried him up to the jail. Well, they carried him up to the jail, and he shot him down on a bright May morning. And they swiftly laid his corpse away. Who mourns the death of this great man? Who mourns the death of this great man? Oh, bury me down in yon green garden with Union men on every side. Oh, they buried him down in yon green garden with Union men on every side. And he swore they would form a mighty weapon, that James Connolly's name would be filled with pride. Where, oh, where is our James Connolly? Where, oh, where is that gallant man? He's gone to organize the union, so that working men they might yet be free. There you go, lads. James Connolly, the working man. Right, who was looking for Vac Home and Derry? Somebody was.
Gary O'Brien over
there. Oh, Gary was. Gary's looking for it. Okay.
For tomorrow, it's Mark McGuinness, the 70th birthday, obviously, today.
Right, folks, just as a tribute to Martin McGuinness, who would have been celebrating his 70th birthday today. Rest in peace, Martin. This is a song written by Bobby Sands, and made famous, of course, by Christy Moore. A song called Vac Home and Derry.
In 1803, we sailed out the sea, out from the sweet town of Derry. For Australia bound, with the gittin' all round, the marks of our feathers we carry. In our rusty iron chains, we cried for our way. A good woman we left in sorrow. And the main sails afore, the curses we heard on the English and tops of tomorrow. At the mouth of the foil, they threw out to the soil, the down below the deck we were lying. Or dirty stream broken into the dream by a vision of old Robert dying. The sun burnt the screw, the British tells the rule that a cutter was down with the fever. 60 rebels today, but for Monkey Bay, how many will reach their fever? Whoa, whoa, I wish I was back home in Derry. Whoa, whoa, I wish I was back home in Derry. Hell, as our round bottom swell, the ship danced like a moth in the firelight. White horses rode high as the devil passed by, taking souls to Hades by twilight. By weeks out to sea, we were now 43. We buried our comrades this morning. In our own slime, we were lost in the time, and was not good of dawning. It's a hell for a man. He went out his whole life for slavery. When the climate is raw and the gun makes the law, may the wind and the rain here for bravery. 20 years have gone by, I bet with my boss, my comrades don't walk behind me. A rebel I keep, I still stand on the cold of night you will find me. Whoa, I wish I was back home in Derry. Whoa, I wish I was back home in Derry. Na 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 na.
black and tans,
okay.
Broad black brimmer as well, and old, that buys the old brigade.
Right, that's enough, because I also have to do Kevin Barry there for Alan as well.
What?
I know it's 20 to 10 already.
Okay.
Time just flies when you're enjoying yourself here in the rag kitchen, you know. So now, what was the first one I did? The black and tans.
Couch black and tans.
Okay. Especially for Leo for Edgar.
And actually...
Bastard.
He's looking for a rock and rock all as well.
We have enough.
Alright,
we can't do any more. Tomorrow's another day, folks. I'll be back on stage here in the Rag Kitchen at 8 o'clock tomorrow night. There's only, as most of you already know, if not all, I can't go beyond 10 o'clock.
There's an event up. Everyone say they're coming.
There is an event up for tomorrow night's gig. Russell says to remind you all, please go ahead and click going. And we'll see you all tomorrow night. So, just for Leo Varadkar, that scumbag who's sneaking his way into power again. I was born on a double street where the line was to be, and the loving English speak, they want all over us. And every single night when we die with the home we invite the neighbors down with the chorus. Come out, you're a black and tan, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wife how you want medals down in Flanders. And how the IRA made your own life all the way from the green and lovely land of British Canada. Come, let us hear you tell how you slung the red panel. Well, you thought the well it truly persecuted. Where are the seers and gears that you'll only let us hear? When our leaders of 16 were executed. Shut up, you black and tan, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wife how you want medals down in Flanders. And how the IRA made your own that never away from the green and lovely land of Billy. Come tell us how you slew them all our three white two. Like the Zulus they have feared the bow and arrow. How bravely you think one with your 16 pound a gun. And you frightened them and they didn't see the marrow. Come out, you black and tan, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wife how you want medals down in Flanders. And how the IRA made your own life fell away from the green and lovely land of Hillish Sanders. Now the time is coming fast, and I think the days are here when each English son in heel runs before us. And if there be a need, then our kids will say Godspeed with a nurse or two of singing this much forward. Come out, you black and tan, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wife how you want medals down in Flanders. And how the IRA made you run like hell away from the green and lovely land of Flanders. Come out, you black and tan, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wife how you want medals down in Flanders. And how the IRA made you run like hell away from the green and lovely land of Billingsgander. Come out, you black and tan, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wife how you want medals down in Flanders. And how the IRA made you run like hell away from the green and lovely land of Billingsgander. Come out, you black and tans. In Mountjoy Jail, one Monday morning, high upon the gallows
Kevin Barry gave his young life for the cause of liberty. Just the last of 18 summers, get as he walked his death that morning, proudly held his head on high. Just before he faced the hangman, in his dream British soldiers tortured Barry just because he would not tell the name of his brave comrade. Another thing torn in form, armor will kill you. Kevin Barry answered no. Proudly standing to attention as he bid to his broken-hearted mother, who sad grief no one can tell. For the cause he proudly cherished, this sad part then to death walked softly smiling, that old Ireland might be free. Another barge for old Ireland, another whose cruel laws may kill the Irish, but can keep their spirits down. Lads like Barry are no cowards. From the for our sake, they live and die.
There you go, lads, Kevin Barry. Right, Russell, pick up one more of them. I've only time, guys, for one more, because honestly, if I go back to past 10 o'clock, the guards were banging at my door at 3 minutes past. That's just the way it is, I'm sorry. I'd love to go on longer, but hey, I can't.
Slow or fast?
What's that?
Slow or fast?
Fast.
Man behind the wire.
Was that Elsewhere?
There was, just still, Paul McGarry?
No, there was one before that.
Rock and Rock All?
Yeah, we'll do that one. Right, we're going to rock on, rock all. Who is that for?
Brian Hagen.
Brian, okay. All right, Brian, just for you, this is the last song of the night, folks. I'm going to sing the national anthem after this one because I don't want to give them any excuses. I will be back here in the Rag Kitchen with my sidekick, Russell, in the Rag sitting room tomorrow night, 8 o'clock. So please feel free to come and... Bridget, is what a rebel song? Kevin Barry? Seriously?
Rock on, rock all.
Rock on, rock all. Of course a rebel song. Of course a rebel song. Rock on, rock all, you'll never fall. Britain's greedy hands. You'll meet the same resistance as you did with Bobby Sands. Yeah? Right, folks, good night. And I'll see you all tomorrow night. Now, listen, there's a lot of people starting to get a little bit uneasy about being locked down, but stick with it. Take care of yourselves and take care of each other. Stick with it, folks, because... Who's buying me pints?
It comes up as Molendick. Who was that again? It's
Alien.
It's a different name that comes up on it. Foreign Mandukic, I think. What's his first name? He comes up as
Mandukic
on the...
I have no idea. Right, anyway, look...
thanks for a few...
thanks for a couple of pints. Whoever sent it in there, Russell can't figure out what it is.
Airy Molendick.
Airy Molendick. Okay. Thanks for a couple of pints, anyway. And it's very much appreciated.
Albrecht.
Are you telling me you're after Scutter? You're after scuttering around for 2 minutes trying to tell me it was Albrecht?
Yeah, because it comes up funny on this. Ah,
here. Russell's losing the plot, lads. Definitely. He's back in sleep and told him what he didn't get out of it at 5 o'clock today.
I only had one can, good.
Oh, now I understand. He's not going off the head. He's only had one can.
I need more.
Exactly. He now only has 10. Ah, no, he really doesn't. Not really. Anyway, I have to go, folks. Good night. Holy Empire's finished, no foreign lands to see. Thought he'd read the eye of England, heading towards the sea. 200 miles from Donegal, there's a place that called Rock On, and the group behind is quite tall, and grabbing at its wall. Oh, Rock On, Rock On, never fall. What Britain's greedy hands, oh, you meet the same resistance like you did in many lands. May the seagulls rise above your eyes, and the water corrupts your shell, and the natural gas will burn your eyes and blow you all to hell. Well, this rock is part of Ireland, where Britain is folklore. When Finn McCool took his out of gas and threw it into the core, then he passed the pebble across the sea. Wherever did it fall? For the sand became the Isle of Man. Got the pebbles on Rock All. Oh, Rock On, Rock On, never fall. For Britain's greedy hands, all you meet the same resistance like you did in many lands. Made the seagulls grind above your eyes, and the water corrupts your shell, and the natural gas will burn your ass and blow you all to hell. Well, the seas will not be silent while Britannia drives the waves, and remember that the Irish will no longer be your slaves. And remember that Britannia, well, he rules the waves no more. So keep your hands up, Rock On, she's Irish to the core. Oh, Rock On, and never fall. But Britain's greedy hands, oh, you meet the same resistance like you did in Bobby Sands. May the seagulls rise above your eyes, and the water corrupts your shell, and the natural gas will burn your ass and blow you all to hell. And the natural gas will burn your ass and blow you all to hell. you go, folks. And that's it from me tonight as well, folks. So I will be seeing you all hopefully tomorrow. And please spread the word to everybody. McMorris back in the Rag Kitchen. Be here tomorrow night. And I'll be gone again for a while, I'm afraid, because Princess Her Majesty will be arriving on Monday. So I will stay safe as best we can anyway, lads. We really will, Bridget. And but you will see y'all tomorrow night. With a bit of luck. And anybody who hasn't bought the CDs already, will you please do so? And if you haven't bought us a pint already, will you do that as well? Try to keep us all sane here. Thank you very much. Good night. See you tomorrow.
Can it be no more at all? Long I'll tell her, shall live, Connie, around the view.